on a discount, right? That's all right. All right. That's all right. Okay, what do you got? We got Bo. Bo, all right, Bo?
Hi.
Are we Bo, right?
Yeah.
We have Emma, Mira, Kayana, Malaya, Silverio?
Yes.
Silverio?
Yeah.
All right, Taylor Ogden, Bo.
Cypher.
Cypher.
Yes.
Cypher?
Yes.
Cypher. Ava?
Mayama.
Mayama?
Yeah. It's like Mayamo, but like Mayama.
Mayama. Grace Schlager, Tracy Haynes, Taylor Campbell. Okay, sounds good. Alright, thank you. He's right there up against the wall.
There you go. Is he in the black?
He's in the back, yeah. Okay. In his name and his partner's name.
He's to the...
He said, excuse me, we're not some good night. Get your ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Rockham High School for tonight's action, Sheffield Hill League action. Somebody listening to that? Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to Thunder Basketball, campus of Rockland High School. First class of Lady Thunder, who come in at 12-13 on the season, against the Eagles from Delaware, who are 17-8. I'm Gail Aguilar, Brandon Gibson, for tonight's call of Rockland Basketball. Brandon, how are you doing tonight? Jonathan Nagel and you got all the names? You're gonna have to get all the names.
All of them?
Yeah, because they're gonna be in the game, right?
Yeah.
I just wrote down the stars, you're gonna have to get all of them. Because you're the person calling names.
Yeah, I just figured I would just say the last name. And...
Nah, you might. Sometimes Mary's easier than the Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to Thunder Basketball on the campus of Rockland High School on senior night. First off, the Lady Thunder, who come in at 12-13 on the season against the Eagles of Del Oro at 17-8. I'm Dale Leckenberg with Brandon Gibson. Brandon, how are you doing tonight?
Doing pretty good tonight. The Rockland Thunder here at home trying to take home an honorary win for the seniors. They're taking on the Del Oro Eagles here in Rockland. They're going to be hoping to take home a win. What about you, Dale?
Well, you know, for every game that we come out here and play, our girls have had a great season. They've had a great career here at Rockland High School. We have five seniors tonight. But for tonight's game, we want to go over the keys to the game. Brandon, what do you got for Del Oro?
So for us to stop Del Oro, it's going to be hard to stop Del Oro without stopping Maddie Perry. Maddie Perry coming out averaging 16 points per game, almost 12 rebounds. She's really good. She's the leading scorer for Del Oro in their team's history. She's going to be looking to even put more points onto that. So the first key, I'd say, is to stop Maddie Perry. The second key is to get inside position and box out on misses. They got a really tall team for Del Oro, and it's going to be hard to get rebounds with that effort. The last thing is to force the ball out of Butcher's hands. She's a really good ball handler, and if you let her get into her pace, it's going to be hard for us to control it. How about you?
I'll tell you what, for Rockland Thunder tonight, Kiki Scott is out with a concussion. So Mira McCarley, a senior, she's really got to step up and provide the scoring that Kiki provided. Kiki was averaging 10 points a game. We need that from Mira tonight. You know, also one of our best players is Emma Wolfing. She's really got to hit a couple threes tonight to keep Rockland into this game. As a guard, she's really got to play big. And of course, our freshmen. Our freshmen really have to come out and play tonight. Mary has done a great job this year, averaging 14 points a game, and she's got to be ready to play tonight. So with that, welcome to Rockland Basketball, and let's have a good game tonight. Welcome back. That was Rockland High School Drumline. Tonight we want to go over some seniors for Rockland High School. They were just honored from our announcer, Steve Paul. And we'll just go over those seniors tonight. They've had a great career here at Rockland High School, Brandon. And first off, we have Emma Wolfing. Emma Wolfing's, they've all been four-year players. Emma's been a three-year starter, so great job by Emma. We also have Mira McCarley. Mira's also been a four-year player, along with Kiana Trimmer, Grace Schlager, and Ava Mayama. These girls have had a great career here at Rockland High School. And we hope they'll continue to play, not only here at Rockin' High School, but wherever their future endeavors take us. I know Emma's going to try to work over at Dominican. She's going to go to school there. So really good program, and they're going to provide a lot for our underclassmen as we continue through the season. So, Brandon, for tonight's game, we should be off here in about another minute. So,
Yeah, you know, the seniors, they got to be really wanting to win here tonight for their last game of the season. They want to go out with a bang.
Absolutely. We will have the starting lineups presented on the loudspeaker from our announcer tonight, Steve Paul. So Steve should be ready to go, and then we should have a tip here in just a moment. Good luck tonight.
Still. Give it up one more time for Maddie. Give it up for her.
Once again, that was Maddie McKillop on our national anthem. Senior here at Rockland High School. Ready to go for Thunder basketball. All the seniors are starting tonight for Rockland, which is customary. And for Del Oro, they do have a little change in the lineup. Livy Wood is starting for the Eagles. So with your play-by-play tonight, Brandon Gibson.
All right, I'll be here
all
for
right,
the tip.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, this is Del Oro and Rockland. It doesn't matter if it's basketball, baseball, football, basket weaving. This is Del Oro Rockland. Del Oro fans, you ready to go? Rockland fans, you ready to go? Senior night, here we go.
He's jumping.
All right, for Rockland, we got jumping number 35, Kyle Warner. Jump goes to Del Oro, but there's a foul on the court.
Give it up for the seniors, everybody.
Inbound to Del Oro. Pass outside, an inside dribble drive. Foul called on Mira McCarley. It's going to be two free throws for Livy Wood to start the game for Del Oro. Everything's good. Offensive rebound, Del Oro. They shoot a three. No good. Rebounded again by Del Oro. Put back. Good.
Madison Butcher
on the put back.
We talked about early, Brandon. Madison Butcher. She is their point guard. And if she's in rebounding, we're in trouble.
Inside drive, no good from Rockland. Del Oro on the fast break. Mulos surveying the court. Pump fake in the lane. A drive. Blocked. Maddie Perry blocked off on her first shot attempt.
That's pretty good defense for Rockland there.
Yep.
Maddie is the all-time leading scorer and rebounder in Del Oro history. And they've had over 20 league titles. So very established program. And Maddie's the best ever play at Del Oro. We'll get to see that tonight.
Mulos takes advantage of the closeout, gets to the rack for two.
That's two offensive rebounds for the Eagles, and a steal by Maddie Perry.
There she is. But they steal it right back.
Emma Wolfing for the shot.
Wolfing for 2 points. No good, rebounded offensively.
Should be Del Oro's ball. No, Rockland ball.
Gonna be Rockland ball.
Emma tried to get that little jump shot and let the defense go by, but just came up short on that.
Wolfing inbounds. A 3-point attempt by Wolfing. Just barely off. Rebounded by Maddie Perry. 3 from Del Oro comes up just short. And another offensive rebound. And it earns him a trip to the free throw line. Maddie Perry already being active on the boards to start the game.
This foul on Mary Carter there. That's her first. That's going to be huge if we get through this game. Del Oro's quite tall, and they're going to give the freshman Mary Carter a little run for her money.
We mentioned that as the keys to the game to stop them from getting the offensive glass. And it's already something they've been struggling with.
After that first timeout, Del Oro got the early 6-point lead, 6-0.
30-second timeout. That's a half a minute.
Coach Herford calls that early timeout. You know, we have this situation where, you know, I'm sure they practiced that they wanted to keep Del Oro off the boards. And early on, those four early offensive rebounds, it's going to be hard-pressed to keep Del Oro away from the basket if they keep getting those offensive rebounds. Del Oro is coached by Sean Huckabee. This is Sean's fourth year at the helm. You might notice on the back of the Del Oro jerseys, there's a T. That's for Coach Takayama, who passed away in 2016. 29 years as a coach at Del Oro. He's a Rockland resident, and he's missed every day in our community, Loomis community, and in the basketball world. So always paying tribute to Coach Takayama.
Rockland once again inbounding the ball.
Looks like Mady Haynes is checking in for Mayor McCarlin.
Del Oro already running a full court press to start the game. They want to make sure to be pressuring the Rockland offense to start it off.
I've officiated Del Oro twice this year already, and full court press both games the entire time. So when your average height is 6 foot tall across the board, the press is really gives teams the trouble.
Still staying active in the backcourt is Del Oro. Inbound to it. And Mary Carter loses the ball after being inbounded on the dribble drive. Del Oro inbounds the ball. Quickly breaks through the Rockland defense. A pull-up jumper for Maddie Perry, no good. Rockland still looking to get their first points of the game.
As you see, Mary Carter is our point forward. As a freshman, she's our points leader, rebound leader, and she takes care of the ball on both ends of the floor.
The turnaround fadeaway jumper for Wolfing comes up short.
Kayla Tremmer with the rebound.
A three-pointer, just off. A foul on
Kayana Tremmer. Kayana Tremmer on that foul. It's nice to see Rockland on the full court press as well.
They're looking to put the pressure on Del Oro early, which was one of our keys to the game.
Again, they got the ball out of Madison's hand.
But they gave up a mid-range shot. Not a great look.
Natalie Mulas.
That's Natalie's fourth point of the game so far. She's a very good shooter from that mid-range, 12, 14 feet.
She's been attacking closeouts great so far this game. So Del Oro comes up with a 9-0 lead to start off the game. Rockland looking to stop the bleeding. Maddie Perry inside. Layup no good. Butcher with the score.
That was a great outlet pass after Maddie Perry's drive. Just a quick out. And Malaya to Gracie for the basket. So really good to get on the board there on stopping Maddie Perry and then back in the scoring column for Rockland.
There's a back out. Three-point attempt. Just off. Once again with the full court press. An inside drive gives up a open three.
That was Cassie Guevara who came in the game for Rockland. She just got pulled up from the JV team. So it's good to see her out out here getting some varsity minutes as a sophomore. When those seniors graduate, Rockland is a very young team with three freshmen on the roster, so really good to see her on the court tonight.
Haynes again with the ball, gets fouled.
Check that. Cassidy's only a freshman, so Rockland has three freshmen up on the varsity team right now.
Rockland's got a young team this year. They're looking to build another great franchise with Hereford as the coach. Three-pointer goes up. It's good.
Oh, Mary! The three drops it.
Maddie Perry.
That was actually Mary Carter, freshman Mary Carter for the three.
Mary Carter for three.
It's also a turnover by Del Oro there. Rockland's got a good pressure. I'm really excited to see that. I was at the Folsom game last week, and Folsom had all the pressure. But it's nice to see Rockland really putting on the pressure tonight, causing Del Oro a little trouble.
Fast break, layup. Floater shot, no good. Perry gives it off. Del Oro works it around into the post. In and out. Another closeout situation gives up an open look. Spin move in the lane. Floater, no good. Rebounded again. Deloro is dominant on the offensive rebounds. Crossover in the lane for Maddie Perry. Comes up short.
Rockland.
Fast break. Pull up jumper. It's good.
Rockland making a run here.
That's a 7-0 run for Rockland.
Absolutely. You know what? It's good defense. And you got to rebound a little bit better, but their offense is starting to click a little bit.
Nice! Natalie Moulos. Timeout on the court. Timeout Del Oro. 30-second timeout for Del Oro.
Sean Huckabee takes a timeout.
Take a break on the broadcast for a timeout.
We're back here on the broadcast. A dribble drive in the lane gives Rockland a shooting foul, which will give him a chance to put two more points on the board.
She's going to shoot two free throws. Ava.
Good to see Ava back in the game. As she started the game, she came out back in the game.
This is the second free throw. Rebounded again by Maddie Perry.
Once again, Del Oro 11, Rockland 7, early action. Actually, only one minute to go in the first quarter.
Working into the post again. Maddie Perry, another hook shot. Gets a shooting foul, two more points. Available for Del Oro.
This is a third matchup between the two teams. Rockland lost earlier in the season in their own tournament, 56-53. It was a great game by both teams. The second time around, Rockland had a few injuries. Fell 55-33, but early on, really good basketball with two free throws there from Maddie Perry.
She connects on both free throws. To Carter. Top of the key. Gets it to the corner. Out of bounds off of Del Oro. Once again, being active on the defensive end.
Rockland only has 10 seconds on the shot clock after that tip out of bounds. And you know, Brandon, I absolutely agree with you. The length of Del Oro can cause a lot of teams trouble, especially when they're pressing.
I mean, we've just seen how many times here, so many.
Gets
Rockland three more points.
That's five points early on for Gracie off the bench. Really provided that spark Rockland needs.
It seems like Rockland's finding more of an offensive rhythm.
100%. And again, you know, one of the things we talked about is we got to pressure Madison Butcher. And Emma did that right there. Even though she got the foul, again, keeping pressure on the guards is extremely important tonight.
Butcher on the inbound. Taylor to Perry. But there's another foul on Rockland. Off ball.
Kiana with the foul there, but you know, she has done a great job on Maddie Perry. Maddie Perry only has four free throws tonight. She's missed three shots. It's really good defense by Kiana and the rebound by Gracie there.
You can tell the defensive activity from Rockland is really paying off as they've gotten themselves back into this game after starting 9-0.
Senior night does that to girls, you know, they want to win for their seniors, and even though they're the underdog coming in, playing hard, working as a team, sharing the basketball, and putting the pressure on Del Oro. Mira returns the game as Kiana exits with an early two fouls, but she's really played some great defense against Maddie Perry tonight.
Fast pace for Del Oro. Loses the handle, out of bounds on Del Oro. Rockland's going to get the ball back with the chance to tie up the game. It's a one-possession game.
Some of you might have heard the name Maddie Perry before. Maddie plays on the track, or she plays volleyball. She plays tennis. She's on the track team. I talked to her earlier, and she's going to try lacrosse this year. All-around great player.
Score is 10-13, Del Oro, at the end of the first quarter.
We've got steak and lobster sandwiches.
Rockland could be in foul trouble there. They do have 16 fouls, which puts Del Oro in the bonus. So from the whole entire second quarter, whatever, anytime Rockland fouls, Del Oro's would be going to the line. So I do like the pressure defense, but it is causing a little bit of trouble there.
Yeah, the last thing you want as a basketball player is to give up points with the clock stopped. So that's going to be rough for Rockland to try and defend now for the rest of the game with basically their hands tied behind their back.
Hey, fans, I want to just remind you that the Rockland family and the Del Oro family have decided tonight.
Rockland is sponsored by ServPro, your local service provider.
Hospital, so
they do everything from remodels, any in-home service. So on the screen, you should see ServPro in your local community. Please come out and visit our local ServPro and one of our major sponsors tonight, who's providing this broadcast for us, and the sports department here at Rockland High School. Once again, the game is 13-10 after the first quarter.
Del Oro leads. Inbound Del Oro. Taylor with the rock. Perry in the post. Gets inside. No good again.
Gabby Keim with the rebound there.
A three-pointer goes up for Del Oro. Another offensive rebound. Rockland finally pulls down the board. The fast break. McCauley open in the corner. She shoots a three. Just barely off. But a great offensive rebound from Carter.
Should be Rockland's ball.
Rockland will inbound.
speaking of Rockland's ball, Jonathan Nagel is the official taking the ball out of bounds, and Anthony Gray's underneath the basket. They're going to be our officials tonight for not only the girls' game, but the boys' game as well. I've worked many games with Jonathan Nagel throughout the years. Very good official. And Aaron Grave worked just about maybe three games over the years, but does a really good job. We have a good set of officials tonight.
And a fast break score gives Del Oro two more points. They're looking to stop the bleeding of the Rockland run.
It was Megan Williams who gets into this book tonight. It's her first points of the game. She gets about 23 minutes a game, though, so she's on the floor a lot for Del Oro. Maddie Perry with her hands again. She's all over the floor. You know, one of the neat things, Brandon and I were doing a little research, and, you know, Brandon noticed on a picture that Maddie was using her left hand, and he said, oh, she's left-handed. I said, she's any hand she wants, right hand, left hand. She shoots with both hands, outside, inside. So,
as we mentioned previously, she's a multi-sport athlete, so she's got a lot of skill and a lot of natural talent in basketball. Pull-up jumper from Carter, no good. Del Oro. And a wide-open three. Rebound to McCarley, but a foul.
Let's foul on Maddie Perry.
Severo checks out of the game. Gracie checks in the game and immediately pulls up for a three. It's barely off, back iron. Fast break. Layup is just off from Del Oro. And if Rockland's coming back with the fast break of their own, pull up three, just off.
Gracie hit two early baskets there. She's trying to get her second three and third basket of the night.
Perry pulls up for a three. It's barely off. Perry's been shooting a little bit rough tonight. Rockland's been following our keys to the game. Pull up three from McCauley is good. All of a sudden, it's a two-point game. Rockland's right in the rearview mirror of Del Oro.
That was a big break for Rockland. Mirror, Del Oro bench thought she double dribbled, but Mr. Nagel didn't see it, and Mirror buried the three. So, Katy Perry to the line again. She's 4 for 4 from three free throws tonight.
Let's see if she can cash in on two more. Although she's been struggling with her shot, she's been doing a great job getting to the free throw line and keeping Del Oro active on the offensive end, even when Rockland's coming in storming hot. The first free throw is good. And she connects on both free throws. She is 6 for 6 from the line so far this game.
That improves the score 17 for Del Oro and 13 for Rockland. With 5 minutes and 30 seconds to go in the first half.
Rockland, once again on a fast break, gets to the line for two points. Rockland's been connecting on a lot of their fast breaks.
Has been invited to the free throw line to shoot 2 free throws.
It's exciting to see Rockland getting out, pushing the ball, getting breaks. Ava there with the left hand. I taught her that back when we were coaching Thundercats, back when she was in fifth grade. We won the championship. Emma was on our team.
You know what they say, defense wins championships, and Rockland's been playing some great defense to start this game.
100%. You know, they're starting to rebound better. Those first 3 or 4 possessions, Del Oro had 4 offensive rebounds. We've really shut that down in the last 5 minutes, and that's why we're back in this ballgame.
Free throw is rebounded by Del Oro. Oh, but stolen by Rockland. A chance for 2 more points. Carter. Jab step in the lane. A floater is good. Rockland answers. 2-point game once again. And just like that, Del Oro comes back down with 2 more points of their own. They're very quick with the ball.
That's Navi Moulis, his 8th point of the game.
McCarley with the pump fake. Throws a skip pass. Just off the back iron.
I'm excited to see Rockland drive in and getting good shots. They're not driving all the way home. They're pulling up for that little 6-8 footer because of the length of Del Oro. But they're doing a good job beating the initial pressure defense and getting that open look. It is Rockland's ball out of bound after that block.
The inbound. Almost lose the ball, but they throw it back out to the perimeter. A three-point shot, barely off back iron.
We had a good look at that on this angle. I thought that was in by Gracie. She has 5 early points. She was looking for another 3 there.
That would have been huge for Rockland. It would have cut the lead yet again. And Perry loses the handle. It opens up a fast break opportunity for Rockland. The travel's called on Rockland. It's going to be Del Oro ball.
Kayana Trimmer, she returns to the game and right away puts the pressure on Maddie Perry, turns the ball over. I'm thinking that's her 3rd steal of the night. She's doing a great job as a senior on senior day, getting in, facing one of the best players in the area, really shutting her down.
Perry pulls up for a 3. Nothing but net.
Madison Perry.
That is her 1st 3 of the game after those 6 free throws.
Rockland gets her inside. Euro step in the lane. Layup just short. Off the back iron. Gets it back out to Perry. Wide open 3 for Del Oro. And the rebound putback gets him to the free throw line for another 2 points. Their activity on the offensive rebound doesn't always get them automatic points, but it gets them a lot of free throws, and that comes up huge later on in the game.
Maya Stroutman at the line.
First free throw, no good.
Sometimes, hey, they give you 5 fouls. In a game like this, it's not all bad to use them.
Yep.
Malaya checks in for Cassidy.
Rockland inbounds. Looks to beat the full court press of Del Oro.
Rockland had 3 freshmen on the floor there, which is, again, the future is bright for Rockland. But right there, Mary Carter steals the ball.
Carter drives it in over 3 defenders. Jump ball.
Jump ball. Rockland gets the ball.
Rockland looks to inbound.
I think they're going to talk about the shot clock here. Looks like they're going to leave it at 27.
Embed on to Severo. A 3 from Carter. Just off. Offensive rebound for Rockland. A pull-up jumper. No good. But a layup in the rim.
Good points to Mary.
That's Mary's 9th point of the game. She's really coming out strong.
And 1 layup. They just can't stop Maddie Perry from getting to the free throw line.
That's an and 1 play. That thing went in. She's only shooting 1 now. Maddie's trying to get her 12th point of the game with 7 rebounds so far tonight. And she did.
She is perfect from the free throw line in this game. It's going to be an off-ball foul.
Rockland's not in the bonus yet. That is the 6, so for the rest of the 2 minutes and 48 seconds, both teams will be shooting free throws on every foul. The score, 26 for Del Oro, 19 for Rockland.
Wolfing checks into the game for Rockland. Inbounds it to Severo. Pass goes out of bounds for Rockland. It's going to be Del Oro ball on the side. Jumper for Del Oro. It's good. Rockland working it around, trying to beat the Del Oro full-court press, and they do. Gets them a wide-open shot. But it's stolen. Matty Perry with the ball. Passes up an open shot to give a teammate an open shot, but they can't cash in on it. And now a fast break for Rockland. The layup is good. Gracie Haynes with the layup on the fast break.
It's a 7 point for Gracie Haynes. Oh, really good. Really good pressure right there for Rockland. Cassidy Guerrero checks back in. Again, Rockland pulled within seven there. Again, if they can get a couple stops here before the end of the half and go in down two, down three, that's going to be considered a win for Rockland. And go into halftime, see if they can't clean up some of the rebounding. But other than that, they're playing really strong and hard.
And a floater in the lane for Emma Wolfgang gets Rockland 2 points. Cuts it to a 5 point game. But there's a foul in the backcourt on Rockland.
That should be two shots, I believe. Sometimes you're going to get those fouls in the backcourt when you're pressing, but again, really good defense and really good shot there by Emma Wolfing. She's doing a great job.
Gets Madison Butcher to the line for 2 points. She's got the first free throw. It's good.
One of our keys to the game was to shut down Madison Butcher, and we really have tonight. We're putting a lot of outside pressure on her. She's a good shooter, good player. Comes up short, long on that free throw, though.
And a great pass gets Rockland a wide-open layup, but it's just short.
That was a great pass.
Pump fake jabs up in the lane. Gets Del Oro two more points.
Livy
Wood with the 2 points. Stolen by Del Oro yet again. It was a foul. Fouls on Rockland. That'll get them two more free throws. Like we talked about, getting in the bonus early can cause you problems later on in the game.
Cambria Hawkins and Gabby Kine come into the game. Or will be coming into the game. We do have a two-shot foul here with double bonus, so
they'll come in after the first shot, I believe.
Absolutely. Yes. All subs come in after the first shot.
That is true. First free throw good.
Del Oro is 11 for 13 from the free throw line so far in the first half. They're getting in the line and making them.
Welcome breaks the Del Oro press. Carter. Rockland working the ball around the perimeter. Hesitation shot. And seemed to have slipped out of her hand there.
40 seconds left in the half.
Del Oro keeps getting offensive rebounds, but it's going to be out of bounds on Rockland. Gives Del Oro another chance.
Got 32 seconds left in the first half. Del Oro 32, Rockland 23. This is going to be the fourth shot for Del Oro. That's a smart play by Cassie. That ball was going out of bounds. She knew it was off the rebound, so she let that go. Again, the freshmen are really, you know, they're playing above their years, and they're going to hold it for the last shot here with 17 seconds to go. Remember, there is no 10-second backcourt in girls basketball.
If you're Rockland, who's taking this last shot?
It's got to be Gracie or Emma Wolfing right here.
And a foul. Oh, almost an and one three. Just came in and out.
He's going to be asking if that was a two or a three.
DeLauro with the foul.
They clear the court to shoot the free throws as it was at the buzzer.
Has been invited to the free throw line to shoot two free throws.
Mary Carter's looking for her 9th and 10th shot of the game. Looks like they're going to have a little issue with the...
We got 2/10 of 1 second left on the clock as well. Don't go anywhere yet.
I'm not sure 2/10 of a second is enough for Delaware to get off a full court shot, but...
You can. Actually, with 0.3 seconds or less, Brandon... it has to be a tip and a tip only. So this quarter is going to be over.
Mary gets the buzzer, drop.
Mary connects on her free throws. And the full court shot is off. That'll take us into the second half.
Once again, that first half has concluded. Rockland 25, DeLauro 32. Once again, our broadcast today, this is Rockland Broadcasting. This is our second broadcast of the history of Rockland High School. Brandon is a student here at Rockland High School. I'm a teacher just helping out. Again, trying to give students the opportunity to get behind a mic. We have students running the cameras, students running the operations. So again, trying to provide opportunities. Brandon, your first time out, what do you think so far?
It's pretty fun, you know. A lot of the times you watch on the NBA and NFL, you watch these commentators, and then they make it seem so easy. Well, it really is quite a job that goes into commentating basketball games, any games at all, football. It takes some serious skill and practice. What do you think?
I'll tell you what, it's been a lot of fun. I've been thinking about broadcasting for a long time, and it's just a great opportunity to come out and work with young people. We have Arada Jotty, who's going to be working our boys game with us. So just a lot of fun working with players, students. And we also want to thank our sponsors. We talked about ServPro, and our other major sponsor for Rockland Athletics is Dr. David Petty over at Roseville. He's my dentist, and he does a lot for Rockland High School. His kids went to Rockland High School, and his grandkids are now here at Rockland High School as well. So we want to thank Dr. Petty. We also want to thank ServPro as our sponsor for Rockland Athletics. Take a break for halftime festivities. The band should be playing in the background, and we'll see you back for the second half. Once again, Rockland 25, DeLauro 32 on senior night here at Rockland Gymnasium.
Welcome back to Rockland Basketball for the second half of our girls game. Once again, we have the Del Oro Eagles at 32 and Rockland Thunder at 25. It's going to be Del Oro ball to start the second half. And once again, an SFL action.
All right, here we go. Del Oro fans, you ready to go for the second half? Rockland fans, you ready to go for the second half?
It's going to be Libby Wood batting the ball for Del Oro to start the second half.
Nice job, fans. Let's go.
You know, Brandon, we talked in the beginning of the game, you got to limit Maddie Parrish. She does come through with 12 points, 7 rebounds. And so second half, we're going to have to stop Maddie. And also, Natalie Molis, she has 10 points tonight. So if we can stop those two or at least keep them in check, Rockland's got a shot. Gracie Haynes is starting the second half. She did a great job in the first half, so we'll see if we can't get some more threes from Gracie tonight.
Rockland working the ball around. Finds its way to Carter. A great drop pass in the lane, but a block shot from Del Oro gets them a fast break of their own.
Madison Butcher with a good defense there from the side. She's got the ball now in the corner.
They work the baseline to find Maddie Perry, a wide open shot, and it's good.
Madison Perry.
That's 14 for Madison tonight. Almost a steal. Turns into a little fast break. Kiana Tremor.
Oh, shot doesn't fall for Tremor.
That's good left hand there, though. We'll see if Rockland can stay out of foul trouble here in the second half. They got into foul trouble early there, and Del Oro did capitalize, hitting 13 out of 15 free throws.
You got to think the game plan for Rockland is to stay active, but without fouling.
Emma Wolfing with the steal. Maddie Perry steals it right back, though.
A 1-2 step in the lane to a layup doesn't go for Del Oro. And a fast break Euro step. Shot doesn't fall for Carter. Offensive rebound, though, for Rockland.
I think Mary got away with a little foul on that. Del Oro agrees with me.
Shot doesn't fall for Wolfing. Gives Del Oro another fast break chance. A Euro step. It's going to be a foul on Rockland. Two free throws.
A lot of girls on the ground there. I think four of them hit the deck on that one. You know, the game started off there with Del Oro getting the offensive rebounds, and I hate to say it, second half started the same way. Madison Butcher to the line.
First free throw connects for Butcher. If you're Rockland, you have to worry. As we mentioned, the keys to the game, stopping Butcher is a massive key if you want to beat Del Oro, and it seems like she might be finding her rhythm. Knocks down both free throws.
A 30-second timeout for Del Oro.
Del Oro
gets
a timeout, 30 seconds.
With the score of 36 for Del Oro, 25 for Rockland, with 6 minutes to go in the third quarter. That was Madison Butcher. She knocked down those two free throws. She's 3 for 3 on the night from the free throw line. Del Oro continues to shoot well from the free throw line.
Timeout is called.
It's good to have the drum line back in action tonight for the Thunder. And the Storm doing a great job. They're in the house tonight. We have a special night tonight for our senior boys tonight. It's going to be called Silent Night. So the hopes of the Rockland crowd is going to stay silent for the first 10 points of the game, of the boys game. And then when we score 10, they're going to erupt. So we've been working hard as a school on this, and we're going to hopefully pull it off tonight.
As you know, Eck, Rockland has a great crowd and a great student body that loves to support their team. So it's going to be tough for the Rockland crowd to stay silent for the first 10 points, but I'm sure it's going to be a eruption of applause once they get those first 10.
Brandon, that's a good point right there. Our Storm's really done a great job this year on the football field, now here in basketball season. So hopefully they're going to bring it tonight, and should be a good atmosphere here on senior night.
A spin move layup. If Madison Butcher gets her 2 more points, you have to worry that Madison Butcher And yet another steal for DeLoro gets him 2 more points.
That was Livy Wood on the steal and the layup.
Kerford for Rockland hopes to call a timeout to stop the bleeding.
That's 1 minute.
Once again, Rockland Drumline under the direction of Mr. Douglas.
He does a great job with that drum line.
This is our third year, I believe, of the marching band. So not only out of the football games, a spear crew, and of course the drum line. Looks like they got new drums over there. They got like a powder blue drum there. Looks really good. DeLoro's on an 8-0 run to start the second half. See if Rockland can't close the gap here. A little kick out of bounds from the Eagles. Should be Rockland ball. They do have a new shot clock with Malaya trying to check in the game. Looks like it's going to be the next check-in.
If you were wondering if DeLoro was going to stop their full court press, with how it's been going, it's absolutely not happening as they get another steal with pressure defense, but Rockland gets it right back.
That was the one thing in the first half Rockland did very well was the press. So we'll see if we can force another couple turnovers like we had right there.
Carter, right side wing.
Oh!
Blooded from Cassidy gets a Rockland 2 more points. Hopefully that'll start a run to get him back in this game. Matty Perry, no good on the layup.
That was Kayana Tremor with the rebound. Mary Carter, dry coming through the lane.
And she gets fouled. 2 free throws for Mary Carter.
Mary has been invited to the free throw line to shoot 2 free throws.
That was on Livy Wood for the Eagles. Mary to the line.
Rockland looking to connect 4 points together. Maybe get themselves back a little bit in this game. First free throw is knocked down from Mary Carter.
Mary says, I can shoot free throws too. She's 3 for 3 for the night.
Splash, look at that on the second free throw from Mary.
Mary's, she's from a very active family. Mom's a teacher over Springview Middle School. Dad's also a teacher, so she comes from a very athletic family, coaches, and you can tell by her skills.
DeLoro comes right back down the court and says, we can get to the free throw line too. As Livy Wood gets herself 2 free throws. First one is knocked down.
Crowd's starting to fill in tonight, Brandon. We should have a packed house here in Rockland.
Expect an intense atmosphere for the whole rest of this game.
I know we've said this before, Brandon, but you know, you look out on the floor, Rockland's down 12. They have 3 freshmen on the floor right now. And again, with bright future for Rockland, Jenna Herford again, this is her third year. We talked to her beforehand, and you know, she mentioned a 5-year plan. I think Rockland's well on their way to getting back to where Rockland basketball, girls basketball was all about. You know, Frank Shields is our longtime girls coach, and he retired a few years ago. And Jenna's picked it up over the last couple years and really done a great job. And this is the first time in 3 years we've had a freshman team, so it's really exciting to see not only our varsity team playing well, but we also have a great JV team, and we have a really good freshman team as well. So really excited for the future of Rockland basketball. We had Looks like Anthony Gray came in, saw something different for Jonathan Nagel. They're going to have to reset the shot clock. It's going to be Rockland ball out of bounds. Cassidy Guevara is going to be taking it out for the Thunder.
You know, if you look at Delora's defense, you see a lot of outstretched arms ready to steal the ball from the passing lane. It's going to be a foul on Delora.
It was Myers Strowman with the foul.
Rockland gets another chance to inbound the ball.
Not only is it senior night for the girls basketball team, it's also senior night for the boys team. And we can't forget our cheer squad. This is their senior night, as well as our dance crew. So senior dancers, seniors in the house tonight. And a lot of great signs up around the gym. And we have a great crowd tonight to send these seniors off. Now, the season's not over yet, though. There's still two more away games at Oak Ridge and at Whitney next week.
You know, this is an important night for many girls out here. As you can see the way the Rockland girls team is playing, they want to win this game.
That's Madison's fourth point. Sorry about that. Fourth point of the second half. She's really come out strong. Hey!
Crossover in the lane.
Jump ball.
Get her, Madison!
The jump ball is called.
Gracie Haynes back in the game.
Delora gets the ball after the jump ball possession.
With 3:22 left in the third quarter, Delora 43, Rockland 29, as they continue the full court press.
That is one thing that Delora is great at, is getting the ball through the full court press, but a silly mistake gets the ball right back to Rockland.
Brandon, I'm only 5'9", and when you're going up against six-footers like Delora, they see over our girls, they see over me. It really helps to break that press.
And you know, it's difficult to defend a player like that, since a lot of the times their outstretched arms can get a jump shot off right over the top of you without any sort of question. Rockland breaks the full court press and gets a wide open three out of it and doesn't connect.
Again, Gracie Haynes, she's the MVP of the game tonight, coming in off the bench, getting some good rebounds. She's stealing the ball. And she's made early points.
That was good defense there from Haynes, but better offense from Delora right there.
Cambria Hawkins just in the game. That's her first points of the night.
Yet another turnover resulted from great Delora defense.
Timeout on the floor.
Perfect calls a timeout.
60-second timeout for Rockland. That's 1 minute.
Once again, that is a timeout, Rockland, with 2:33 left in the third quarter. Delora 45, Rockland 29. Remember, tonight's broadcast is brought to you by ServPro, your local service provider for all things dealing with your home. It is wintertime, ladies and gentlemen, and I know it's sunny outside, but when the rain comes, make sure you call your local ServPro provider. Mr. Wardlaw will come, give you an estimate. Does a great job. He's a great sponsor here at Rockland High School. So, once again, give ServPro a call for your home needs. Also, don't forget to, if you're in the business of looking for a dentistry, Dr. Petty Dentistry in Roseville, great supporter of Rockland Athletics. And if you're needing some dental work, go see Dr. Petty.
It's going to be Delora ball after the timeout from Rockland. You know, Rockland must have been discussing how they can get themselves back into this game, as it is slipping from them very quickly here.
Well, those turnovers never help. Libby Wood for three.
Just off. But they get themselves yet another offensive rebound. But guess what? A steal, fast break, and a foul. Gets him, going to get them two free throws. Rockland hopefully putting some points on the board to stop the bleeding that DeLauro is causing.
Gracie has been invited to the free throw line to shoot two free throws.
Gracie Haynes gets a chance at the free throw line.
This is Gracie's first free throws of the night. She does have 7 points. Make that 8.
Looking for 9.
I got a good feeling, Brandon. I think she's going to do it.
I think she's going to do it, too. You know, it's coming down to the wire. You know, you got to make some big plays in this game, and you need every free throw you can get. You need every point you can get if you want to try and win this game on senior night.
Macy's a great kid. She's in our sports leadership class. This first year of sports leadership, she's doing a really good job.
You know, if you're Rockland, we're working so hard to get these points and we're giving up easy shots like that. You got to...
Again, Cambria, she's the fifth girl off the bench, and she's 6 foot tall herself. Again, really, really tall team. Mary Carter for 3.
Just off. Hits the back iron. DeLauro on the fast break. Rockland successfully stops the fast break, and now it's going to be a half-court offense. But a pass to Mary. Oh, she smokes the layup. Carter with the rebound. Off to Mira. Rockland sets up offense. Mira with the crossover. Throws it back out. And a great pass inside. Gets Rockland 2 points. Great cut, great pass.
I tell you what, Gracie Haynes there again. We've talked about her defense, offense, and now the great pass to Ava.
She's doing it on all ends of the floor right now.
42 seconds left.
The air ball is rebounded offensively by DeLauro and gets him 2 points.
That was Gabby Klein's first points of the evening. Once again, 24 seconds left in the third quarter. There's a 5-second difference in shot clock with Emma Wolfing. Great rebound from Mary Carter and back in.
The activity on the boards from Mary Carter is paying off for her. She's getting herself some points. Ball goes to Maddie. Scoop hook shot's so good. Buzzer.
That concludes the third quarter with DeLauro 49, Rockland 35. It's a 14-point lead. Again, Brandon, it got up to 16 there. Again, Rockland came back, brought it down again, 2. But at least they stopped the bleeding there. It was trying to get out of hand. Again, Kiana Trimmer comes in, plays great defense. Emma Wolfing came in, played some really good defense. So, again, here in the fourth quarter, Mary really got to step up her game. She's played great. Maybe she can get a couple easy, those little 12, 14 footers.
If you're Rockland, you got to be thinking, this game is just inside reach. If we can get some plays, string some plays together, we might be able to have a chance to come back and win this game.
Definitely limit those turnovers that got us there early part of the third quarter. So, again, if they could take care of the ball, get the ball to their shooters. Gracie Haynes is playing great. Emma Wolfing's had a solid game. Get the ball to those girls. We'll see what we can get us back in the game.
It's going to take some sheer effort, some sheer will, and a little bit of luck from Rockland to get themselves right back into this game.
For the Thunder in the third quarter, Mary Carter had 4 points. Gracie Haynes had 2. And Cassidy Guevara had 2. For the Eagles, Maddie Perry had 2. Madison Butcher had 4. Libby Wood had 3. Gabby Klein had 2. And Cambria Hawkins had 4. So as we start the fourth quarter, Rockland ball. Gracie Haynes inside to Mary Carter. Just out of hands of Ava.
The idea behind the pass was great. Just a little bit too far out of her reach. Not a great way to start the fourth quarter. and they grab down the rebound. It's a great fast break they got going here. 3-on-1, but it's a block shot.
Natalie
Haynes can't connect.
Yeah, Gracie Haynes there. Natalie Morris, she really dominated the first half on offense. Now she's back on defense. So got to reset the shot clock here to 25 seconds for the Thunder.
Going to be Gracie Haynes on the inbound.
Check that, 24. Anthony Gray says 24. Official's done a good job tonight.
They've refereed a fair game so far. I haven't seen any out of the ordinary calls so far. Great passing. Gets a wide open layup, but can't connect yet again.
I'll tell you what, that was a great pass by Mary Carter. Let me see. Here comes Maddie Perry, though.
Maddie Perry with the Euro step scoop shot in the lane. Gets her 2 more points. If you're Del Oro, you're looking to put away this game. 3-point shot goes up. Doesn't fall. It's going to go out of bounds off of Rockland.
Not sure if you can see it from the video feed, but crowd's really filling in tonight. Got about 80% full right now, but lots of kids coming in from the side, so should fill this place up tonight.
It's starting to look like a Rockland High School rally out here. Looks great like passing from Del Oro. Gets them 2 more points.
It's like Maddie Wolfing's down on the ground there.
She takes a hard fall. Let's hope she's okay.
As we take a break in the action for Maddie Wolfing, we've got 6:51 left in the fourth quarter. Del Oro 53, Rockland 35. Looks like we got some trainers coming out. I think it's her ankle.
They're bringing out the medical staff to look at Emma Wolfing's ankle, we think. She gets helped up.
All right, that's Emma. Give it up for Emma.
Once again, senior Maddie Wolfing. Give a nice round of applause. Hopefully she's going to be okay with an ankle. It is going to be Rockland ball out of bounds for the with 6:51 left in the contest here at Rockland High School. Once again, my name is Dale Eichenberg here with Brandon Gibson. This is our second live broadcast in the history of Rockland basketball. We're learning. We're having fun. Brandon, you having fun?
I'm having fun. I'm having a ton of fun out here.
It's not as easy as it seems on TV, huh?
It is not as easy as it seems on TV, remembering names. You got a whole roster of girls to remember.
So if we mess up, just remember this is our first time, but we're having a good time out here trying to bring you a little live basketball. And looks like the fans are trying to officiate as well. That often happens.
Fans often believe that they know better than the referees.
If you're listening and want to get to officiating, the NCAA is looking for officials. We have a lot of people who think they know basketball. Let's get out there and officiate.
Speaking of officiating, the referee calls a foul on Del Oro. It's going to be a shooting foul.
Mary has been invited to the free throw line.
It gets Mary Carter to the line for 2 free throws.
Mary Carter's 4-for-4 from the line.
Let's see if she can keep the streak up. Connects on the first. And the second free throw is good. She's perfect from the line.
I'll tell you what, I've watched Mary. This is probably the sixth game I've watched this year of the Rockland Thunder. When she misses long or short. She makes a lot as well, averaging 14 a game, but really impressive. She's got great line on her shots, and it shows with the free throw there. She brings the ball up, plays good defense, all-around player. Once again, Rockland does have three freshmen on the floor right now.
It's clear from watching her play that she's a player that can do many things on the court. She, as you saw, she just pulled down a rebound, played good defense, and scored. Rockland working the ball around, gets a hook shot on the lane, doesn't fall.
That was Bo Sippler on the shot, another freshman for Rockland High School. She's played some great defense. She hasn't got much playing time today, but in past games she's done a great job. And again, you can only build on that for Rockland High School girls basketball future.
And a scoop shot on the lane gets Madison Butcher 2 points. In the first half, she was a little bit quiet, but she has come out in the second half with a vengeance.
Yeah, she has 8 points here for the second half. Kiana Trimmer trying to get two, and she's going to go to the line with a foul on Madison Butcher.
A good take. Gets her free throws.
Kiana's trying to get on the board here on senior night. It's a good looking shot though.
Miro checks into the game for Gracie Haynes. Offensive rebound. Oh, almost. I spoke too soon there.
Good to see Mary going against Katie Perry, though. She's really keeping Madison Perry in check.
And a three by Mulos. Puts three more points on the score for Deloro. And a Euro step and one layup for Madison Butcher. It's getting a little bit out of hand here.
You know, as you say, it's getting out of hand. It could be, but I'll tell you what. For these freshmen that are on the floor, the seniors in front of this big crowd, they're going to play all the way to the end. And here comes Grace Schlager. She's going to come in the ball game.
One of our
seniors for tonight.
Give it up for Grace.
We were talking about how this was going to be how Rockland's got a young team this year. And you got to believe tough games like these against hard opponents like Deloro is going to be a big developmental opportunity for these young players.
Deloro is one of the top teams in the section, and they're putting on that display tonight with solid play from the backcourt with Madison Butcher and solid play by Maddie Perry. I think the key to Deloro is they have four girls named Madison. We need some more Madisons, baby.
Well, you can only get them if they enroll in the school. There's no such thing as trading in high school girls basketball. So
that's true.
Grace Schlager pulls up for three. Doesn't fall.
She hustles back on defense, though.
At the end of the day, that's all you can ask from a player is hustle. And Rockland's been showing hustle throughout this whole game.
The other one, another Madison Perdello checks in the ball game. Madison Smith for the Eagles.
Rockland beats the full court press yet again. They are working
like
the ball.
Looks like Deloro is trying to extend their defense a little bit.
Carter gets it to Schlager. They're just going to pull up a three. Doesn't fall.
Another rebound by Maddie Perry.
It's going to be two more points for Deloro from Livy Wood on the pull-up mid-range jumper.
9 points for Livy Wood tonight. Once again, if you just join us, number 34 for Deloro, Maddie Perry with the rebound. Maddie is the all-time leading scorer in Deloro history and rebounder. So, all-around great athlete, four-sport athlete at Deloro, and she's going to continue her education and schooling in college and play some basketball. So,
real talented player.
It's like full timeout for Deloro. That's a 60-second timeout with 3:13 left in the game. It's Del Oro 63, Rockland 37.
Timeout. 60 seconds.
Following the girls game, we will have about a 10-minute intermission on the live coverage. And as we get ready for the boys game, Arad Ajadi and myself will be calling the boys game with Brandon Gibson returning for some baseball later on in the season. So pay attention to Rockland Broadcasting and Twitter. We'll be broadcasting our games. Brandon's going to probably have another partner as I'm the boys tennis coach. So maybe we might cancel practice on a Friday and come out and call some baseball games. But Rockland baseball gets started on Monday with practice along with all the other spring sports. Two Rockland alumni did get their first action in college today with Chris Wolfing playing out of Lewis and Clark College out of Oregon. So they got into the action today playing some baseball. Del Oro back at it here with 3 minutes to go in the second half.
Two more points for Del Oro. It's going to be Hawkins with the layup in the lane.
It's Cambria's sixth point of the night.
And they're going to call an offensive foul on Rockland. It's going to be Del Oro ball yet again. Chris Schlager checks out of the game. Gracie Haynes coming back in.
Speaking of baseball, I forgot to mention Clint Walker from Willamette University is also making his debut for college baseball today. So once again, Rockland not only here having some seniors, but we also have young men and women in college playing sports as well. So Malaya with the steal, going for the basket.
And the hustle on defense gets her two points on offense and one.
Yes, he's been invited to the free throw line to shoot one more.
It's her first 2 points of the game, but hey, comes up big, gets the crowd up. With 2 minutes to go, Rockland's at the line trying to complete the three-point play.
They're waiting for a Del Oro player to finish tying her shoes, and she does. She finishes tying her shoes. And Rockland converts on the and-one. Foul on Rockland. Fouls on Mayama. Rockland gets a steal. The three-pointer is off from Gracie Haynes.
Gracie's going to need to get a little more arc on that ball. That's a bullet. But, hey, she scored a couple of those earlier in the game. So, hey, if it works, keep it going.
Del Oro works the ball around the perimeter.
Once again, 1:46 left to here in the game.
Layup is off.
Stay with us for the boys game immediately following.
And a blocking foul on Del Oro. We'll get
foul on Del Oro.
Two more free throws for Rockland.
Mary has been invited to the free throw line to shoot two free throws.
In between games, it should be about a 15-minute intermission. We do have, I believe, eight seniors for the Thunder. And then we'll get the action going shortly after. Once again, we should have a sellout crowd here at Rockland High School tonight for SFL action between the Del Oro Eagles
and the Rockland Thunder.
And as we mentioned previously, it's going to be silent night for Rockland, as they will be waiting until the 10th point that Rockland scores to cheer for any sort of score or anything that happens for Rockland. It's going to be silent until that moment. And then an eruption of applause after the 10th point is scored.
Mary Carter checks out. Again, another great night for Mary Carter. She has a bright future here at Rockland High School. Grace Schlager, playing her last home game, re-enters the game.
And with just a minute, 22 seconds left, Delora leads by 23.
Number three, Maddie Guthrie checks in for the first time for Delora.
Layup doesn't fall for Delora. They get it back.
Also, Taylor Ogden.
Playing her first minutes of the night.
Yeah.
They try to get it to Ogden, but the pass is stripped.
Actually, that was my bad. It's Taylor Campbell. Taylor Ogden's out with a broken nose. I should have known that.
It's all good.
Taylor Campbell with the block there.
From here, we mentioned that it is only our second broadcast.
That is correct. We're learning. So if we don't get your name exactly correct, we've tried. We're working on it. Hopefully you enjoyed our broadcast tonight. Looks like we got an offensive foul on Delora. I want to thank you, Brandon, for coming in. You're a senior. What are you going to be doing next year?
Man, I'm going to be going to Sierra College. I'm going to be studying broadcasting and filmmaking. I'm going to be going into stuff like that. So this is a field that I'm really interested in. So it is a fun experience to come in and commentate for a game, and hopefully many more. Obviously, I've made my fair share of mistakes, but you live and learn. And just as Rockland's going to be living and learning from this loss tonight, we will hopefully be living and learning from this experience broadcasting.
Absolutely. And once again, thank you for tuning in to Rockland Girls Basketball. We've got about 18.9 seconds left, 65-42. Looks like Delora is going to just run out the clock here on senior night for Rockland. But I'll tell you what, Rockland has a bright future. Our seniors tonight, they played really well. And we still got two games left at Oak Ridge and at Whitney. Once again, congratulations, Delora Eagles, on a great night of basketball. Our officials, Aaron Gray and Jonathan Nagel. And get ready for our second game of the night, the boys' varsity game between the Delora Eagles and your Rockland Thunder.
Yeah. High School Hall of Honor brought you up to Senior Night in the Thunderdome. We'd like to take a moment to remind you that your ticket to the night event is a
welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the campus of Rockland High School for Senior Night. We have the Rockland Thunder coming in at 20-5, facing the Dell Eagles here on Senior Night. We are excited to bring you Rockland basketball here on Rockland Broadcast Team on YouTube TV. My name is Dale Eggenberg. I'm here with Rod Jihadi. We're excited. We're going to have the Pledge of Allegiance, and then Rod's going to come back with his keys to the game. Enjoy our Pledge of Allegiance. And our Star Spangled Banner performed by Maddie McKillop.
She is starring in the play 42nd Street here at the high school starting on February 27th. Abby's also in the chamber choir. She's in the Theater 4 that's going to the festival tomorrow at Linnea Festival, Folsom Lake College. And she's on the Dance 3 team. Do you do it all? That's awesome. She started out her singing career at Rock Creek, headed over to Springview, and now she's here at Rockland High School. And tonight, she's going to sing the national anthem for us. This is Miss Abby Dixon.
Broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight. O'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming. And the rockets reckless, the bombs bursting.
Senior at Rockland High School. I mentioned Maddie McKillop. She sang for the girls game, but let's give it up for Abby Dixon. And I think we're ready for some basketball, Rod. What's keys to the game?
Well, you know, Rockland and Deloro, they've had a pass game with Rockland coming out on top in that game, but J.D. Doley, their main player, he's averaging 19 points a game, so we really got to shut him down, give him no space, make him put the ball on the ground.
And now, starting out for the next ball game, first down for the Lower Eagles of Deloro.
Play strong defense last game. Andre was really controlling the paint. He was absolutely dominating in there. So we hope to see the same performance from him this game.
Number five, Ryan Dunmore.
Really needs to watch out for Mason Macasola. He's got 6 assists a game. We really got to put that pressure on him to watch him. You know, we got to make sure they can't get in there. We can't get inside the defense and get those 3 points. So, what do you think of the outcome of this game?
I'll tell you what, Rockland's got to come out. Last game, on Tuesday night, Rockland guards were a little slow coming out. Darius and Donovan had 0 points in the first half. They've got to get started earlier tonight. Get going. If we do that, we're going to have a great atmosphere. Let's stay tuned for the starting lineup for the Rockland Thunder. Nate Harrison will be announcing our game tonight from the court. So, here on Senior Night at Rockland High School, welcome to CL Foothill League Basketball.
Number 11, Noah Cummings.
offense there. All the seniors are starting for Rockland tonight. As you know, we can't make that happen, but Steve Taylor on the Rockland crew did a great job of recognizing all of the seniors. So they announced all of our seniors tonight. But Rockland will have its typical starting lineup with Donovan Lopez, Darius Kendall, Andre Renica, and it looks like Brian Hong and AP Portello are going to come out and round out that starting five. Let's get ready for Thunder basketball. Arad, this is our second opportunity to broadcast for Rockland High School, and really excited to be out here tonight, Arad. What are you looking forward to tonight?
I'm really excited to see Andre really get in there today. You know, all of their previous and past performances, they've really been out top and they've really been performing second half. But I'd really like to see them perform first half. And here we have the ref coming in for the tip-off.
Jonathan Nagel and Aaron Gray are refereeing our game tonight. Two quality officials from the NCAA. And Rockland wins the tip. Donovan Lopez with the ball over to AP. Arad, take it from here.
It's like we got Darius with Andre in the paint. Beautifully executed there.
Hey, you gotta love an alley-oop to start out the basketball game. Gotta love a dunk, especially on silent night. The students are not gonna cheer until the 10th point, but man, it is hard. If you're looking over there, they are throwing their arms, not saying a word. I love silent night here in Rockland Gymnasium.
We have Darius Kendall here, looking for an opportunity. Alex Portella back to Donovan Lopez. Donovan Lopez back to Darius Kendall. Darius really trying to get in there. Ooh, looks like he fumbles the ball here. Ball goes to the Eagles.
That was Aiden Perry with the hands. He's just a sophomore. You might have... Another alley-oop dunk! It is unbelievable tonight to start off with two alley-oop dunks. Andre Renica throwing it home!
Andre is absolutely not underperforming at all here. We got Aiden Perry. They're really putting pressure on him there. Looks like Andre's on the ground. We got Mason Montesola, number 24 from the Delaware Eagles.
The Rockland Thunder storm over there. They cannot believe two dunks, and they are not allowed to say a word. Pay attention for the 10th point. They're going to go crazy tonight here in SFL league play.
We have Darius here being double guarded with the shot. That was beautiful. Goes for the three. Absolutely sinks that.
I can't wait for this crowd to explode. It's a sellout crowd here in Rockland. It's silent night. But again, putting a ton of pressure on the guard play out here. That's Ryland Dunmore getting double teamed.
To shut him down early. He's averaging 19 points a game. We got to really watch him.
Early action, Rockland 7, Delaware 3 with 5 minutes left in the first quarter.
We got Jared Hill, Darius with the overturn. He does make the two, putting Rockland at 9-3. I can't wait until they hit this 10th point, see that crowd erupt.
Our storm section this year has been great. Coach Harder has been running the storm this year. A 100% change from the previous years. Rockland sports are really turning it on here early on in the SFL season in all the sports. Rockland forcing the ball there. You're going to have some turnovers with the Rockland offense. As Coach Taylor said, they want to push the ball. You are going to have some turnovers, but... You're going to score like they have so far this year at 9-3. I'm sorry, in this game.
One time we got Andre getting subbed in, getting subbed out. Apologies. We got Byron Peterson going in, number 32. Gerald Cummings subbed in as well. Looks like Donovan Lopez with the interception. Looks like a strike. Legal use of hands.
That was a great foul by Delora, stopping that fast break. Once again, Rockland 9, Delaware 3, 5:29 left in the first quarter.
Got Darius taking the ball out here. Just goes for the shot.
That is unbelievable. The Rockland crowd going crazy. It is a great out. foul. Let's get Rockland Ball out of bounds. Darius Kendall to Donovan Lopez.
Final chance to try and get in there. Back to Darius. Darius sees Donovan, goes for the shot. Bounces off rim. Got Gerald Cummings on the ball. Sees Alex Botello, goes for three. Misses
a shot. Rockland fans are looking to explode again after that early 12-5 advantage on the silent night game. They're not silent anymore. That's got to be a charge.
Mason Mapusola really getting aggressive in there.
That was an easy call by Aaron Gray there on the baseline. Mason Moncasola, sorry about that, drove in, and Jared Cummings just set up. He set up his tent and 100% charge on that call.
Got Emmanuel Ackman in there. Back to Donovan, back to Emmanuel. We got Darius. Bounces off rim. We got Byron and Mason. Mason Moncasoli. Makes that 12-7, 3:53 left in the first quarter. Donovan and Darius. Darius is looking for Donovan. Donovan goes for the three. Bounces off rim.
JD Dooley with another shot again. He scored. He was the leading scorer for the Eagles last time they matched up there in Loomis. And again, 12-9 Rockland after an early start. After the crowd went crazy with the three by Darius, Rockland's gone scoreless for the last 3 minutes. And DeLore's on a 4-0 run here with 3:21 left in the first quarter. Let's get tonight. Your Rockland broadcast. This is only our third live broadcast in the school history, so we are learning. Arad Ajadi is my co-partner here. Arad, how does it feel calling a little high school basketball?
You know, it's my second time since Tuesday, and I gotta say, it's absolutely thrilling. I just love the action that's going on, and being able to play-by-play announce it is absolutely just really warms my heart. I just love talking. Defense on the five. Mr. Ryland Dunmore.
I'll tell you what. Andre Redica, he just lowered his shoulder, moved DeLore out of the way, and said, I am the best player on the floor. And that is his first 2 points of the game, and it was really dominating on the inside. Check that. That was Andre's 6 point of the game. And that was turnover by DeLore. Darius with the ball through to Emmanuel.
Emmanuel looking for Andre. Andre just goes for it. He rebounds it off his own shot. Looks like we got Mason Moncasola looking for JD Dooley.
DeLore packed the key on that. They had four guys surrounding Andre. Andre, later on, he's going to get that same play, and he's going to kick it out for a three. That was a great Euro step. If you see that, he stepped with his right foot, let the defender go by, stepped with his left foot, then he got hammered. But great Euro step. Donovan's been working on that for the last couple of years. He's going to the line for two. With 2:10 left in the first quarter, Rockland 14, DeLore 9.
Got Donovan with his first three free throw shot. Time we got Nico for Darius Kendall. Looks like Donovan Lopez with three shots made. 69, 210 left in the first quarter.
That's that 6-0 run that Rockland gets quite often. They so much pressure defense that they really pack it in and come up with those big plays. Andre Renica with the rebound. Gerald Cummings pushing up the floor. Got a foul. Emin Mimi is going to be taking it out of bounds for Rockland. Early foul trouble for Del Oro. That's going to be their 15th foul. Rockland hasn't committed a foul yet. We saw in the girls' game, Rockland got into foul trouble. Now we have Del Oro in foul trouble. The whole second quarter, Rockland should be shooting free throws.
Evan Yemi's got two on him. Oh, Gerald Cummings with a shot. Got Evan Yemi with a shot.
Again, Rockland, you can tell they're bigger, they're stronger. They're really pushing Del Oro out of the key. Really solid offensive play. They did the same thing on Tuesday night against Granite Bay. They really powered the inside. Cal Lunders gets in the scorebook. You might have heard the name Cal Lunders. He's the quarterback for Del Oro. Jimmy Summers enters the game for Rockland. Del Oro ball.
Nico really putting that pressure on. You know, he's watching Mason here. He's not giving him an inch of space. He's really putting that pressure on. Oh.
We have an illegal screen by Cal Lunders. Del Oro's trying to get J.D. Dudley open, and Emmanuel's sticking right with him. Emmanuel's 6'3 with long arms. They're really trying to get him, take him out of the game, and setting multiple screens. Rockland fought through that one. They got the foul. Rockland ball, Emmanuel on the wing.
Got Emmanuel to Andre. Andre looking for Jimmy. Jimmy goes up for three.
That's what we talked about 2 minutes ago. They keep packing down on Andre. Andre's going to kick it out to find the shooter. And he did it right there, which is, that's great offense. That's Rockland basketball for you right there. Very unselfish.
He's really putting their team on the board there.
That was a great play by Mason. His dad's sitting right in front of us, very excited for his son. As he should be.
Mason with the free throw, does make it.
That's 5 early points for Mason tonight.
We got Nico to Evan here. Evan looking for Jimmy.
18 seconds to go, Arad, in this first quarter. Rockland's going to take down the clock all the way to zero, trying to end this with the half. I'm going to give you the call here.
We got Rockland ball here.
7.7 seconds to go, Arad. You're going to call the three-point shot right here.
Emmanuel's going to be there for the three-pointer. Rondre's going to be there. He's going to sink that. We got Evan looking for someone. Emmanuel's open. Andre. Oh, looks like Andre. Jimmy tries to put it up.
That was a great no-look pass by Andre. If you see that, the official, he waited to see if that ball went in. He held his whistle. There was marginal contact, turned into excessive contact on that shot. Jimmy Summers for two. That's a great call by Aaron Gray.
Jimmy, I've seen him practicing, and he's really been practicing his free throws, and it's really showing off here as he makes his first free throw point. Going for two.
Jimmy Summers had a great game on Tuesday night against Granite Bay. He was all over the floor, offense, defense.
Yep, and that practice is really paying off. We got... Stone King going for the buzzer beater shot. Rockman leading 6 points, 20-14.
Once again, Servpro is our local service provider for all your home needs. Mr. Wardlock, give him a call for your local Servpro. They're our local sponsors here at Rockin' High School. Not only sponsor this podcast, but all of Rockin' High School. Along with Dr. Petty, your local dentist here in the Roseville Rockland area. Dr. Petty's at his kids go through here. His grandkids are here. He's my dentist. Please go visit Dr. Petty Dentistry. If you'd like to be a sponsor of Rockin' High School Athletics, come see Mr. Spears in the athletic department. He'll get you set up. That is our dance team out performing. This is their senior night as well, along with our cheerleaders on the other end of the floor. And we have senior night here in Rockland, California, with the score after one, Rockland 20, Del Oro 14, Del Oro ball.
We got Jared Hill, Mason Montesolo on the ball. Darius giving him no room here, putting the pressure. Emmanuel with the interception does manage to get in front of that pass. Darius looking for Donovan. 7-1, finds Jimmy.
7-1,
Jimmy gets Darius. Darius finds Donovan. Donovan's trying to get in there, back to Emmanuel. Emmanuel having three on him. Darius pulls up for three. And Emmanuel puts it back up for two. Amazing rebound. For the layup.
That's the one thing about Emmanuel, he's very active. And rebounds like that, putbacks, that's his game. That's what we need.
Yeah, Donovan tried to get the ball back in, but it's like the Delora ball.
That was Donovan Lopez with the near steal there. Great defense. Rockland's up 8 as we begin the second quarter here in Rockland.
Got Mason Montesolo really likes to have the ball for the majority of the game. Looks like Andre just passed the ball by Mason there. Emmanuel looking for two. That's his 5th point of the game.
That's 4 straight for Emmanuel. Look at, he closed out on JD there.
JD looks for it but doesn't manage to get it.
That's a great coaching strategy by Coach Taylor, putting the long, lanky Emmanuel on JD, their leading scorer. McClain Stone King put that one in. They're leaking out. That's just a couple times they've done that tonight.
Well, Alex Patello, the manual, pulls up the
Emmanuel's on fire tonight. That's a 7 point. He's playing great defense on JD Dudley. Rockland increases their lead to 11 at 29-18 with 5:41 left in the second quarter. You're on senior night at Rockland High School. It's also flannel night. If you look in the stands, all the Rockland people wearing flannels tonight.
Mason Montesolo really putting the Del Oro team together. It seems to be the glue for the team. Emmanuel pulls up for three. Bounces off rim.
You know, Rob, they call that a heat check.
Looks like we got Jordan Flores going in for Emmanuel here. J.D. Dudley pulling up the three. Air ball. Finds Mason, though. Mason won.
Jordan Foley's checks in the game. He immediately put on J.D. Dudley. Again, he's tall, he's lanky, and they're going to stick on J.D. J.D.'s not going to get any shots from three tonight. Little hand check foul on Rockland.
Got Mason Moncasola. There is J.D. Dudley looking for it. Donovan aren't giving him, putting the pressure on. Mason again. Mason tries to get in there. Jordan Ford with the block. Looks like Cole Becker with the rebound.
Got a little scrum on the play there. Looks like the officials are going to talk. Looks like the DeLore fans are a little angry. At 0-7 in the SFL, I'm not sure it's the officials that are causing the trouble this year. Rockland's playing really good basketball, and that's one of the scores, 29-20. But great officiating there from Jonathan Nagel coming in, making sure they got the call right. They're going to fix the shot clock here. But again, everyone wants to blame somebody. Tonight, DeLore's blaming the officials, but it's Rockland basketball at its finest. Lots of pressure, good shooting, while the score's 29-20.
You know, Rockland being 6-1 in league, you know, no surprise. They just play beautiful basketball.
Again, let's go. Good defense, Rockland.
We got AJ Victor, 14. This is Darius Kendall. Donovan here. Jordan Flores. Looking for Cole Becker, finds Jordan again!
You gotta love the backdoor action! Rockland set up on the wing, cuts backdoor, easy layup for Jordan Flores. We didn't see Jordan on Tuesday night. Comes in, plays good defense, gets on it, gets in the scoreboard.
Aiden Perry pulling up the three, doesn't make it. Got him and taking it down. Got him on the right wing, Jordan Flores.
Yeah, Jordan, he didn't know what to do there. He faked the three and drove to the hole, forgot to put the ball down. So, no little ball.
Looks like we got Jordan on Cal Wonders. Aiden Perry finds Cal Wonders. Left in the second quarter. Rockland still keeping that 11-point lead. We got Mason pressing for more three there. Backs up. Jordan giving him no space there. Really trying to get the ball out of his hands. Pass to Aiden Perry. AJ on him. Finds Mason again. Mason tries to get in there. Andre with the defensive rebound. You know what? Rockland is just absolutely punishing him for the mistakes. Looks like Cal Wonder's trying to pull up the three and he missed it up.
You gotta love three dunks earlier in a high school basketball game. Yeah, that extends the lead to 35-20 with 2:42 left in the second quarter. Rockland goes on those 6-0 runs, 8-0 runs, really, you know, pushes the score up. That's their trademark. We've been doing this for over 20 years here at Rockland High School with Coach Taylor. And again, pressure defense, good offense.
That's J.D. Dudley. Gets two. You know, we got, no one's watching him when he goes in there. Donovan doesn't get three. Got Aiden Perry with the ball. Finds Daniel Brown. Jay's got what he do. Tries to put it
I don't have 55 on the score sheet. Actually, we do. Mr. Grimes just got in the ball game. That's the 11th point for Donovan in the first half. He's really come out strong tonight. And Rockland really pressuring the ball here.
Kyle Lunder is coming for two. Doesn't get it. Andre, defensive rebound. AJ finds Darius. Jordan Flores. Got AJ again. AJ's got Andre in there. Looks like he's really pushing up. He's got three on him right now.
And Roddy hit that right on the head there. Again, they're triple teaming Andre. And he will continue to kick that ball out for three. So 15 on the shot clock. Nick O taking it out of bounds. Rockland up 38-24.
Nick O finds Evan. Evan Niemi. Gerald Cummings on the ball. Gerald finds Emmanuel. Pulls up for three. Doesn't manage to get it in. Looks like we got Evan on the ground here.
A little bad break for Rockland there. We had two guys for that offensive rebound. Just came up, a little fumble action, jump ball. It's going to be Delaware ball with 54 seconds left here in the second quarter.
We've got McClain stonking here, finds Mason, left hand man. Got JD Dooley taking out the ball. Finds Riley Dunmore. Mason Montesolo on the ball here. Nick O watching him. Nick O with the hustle. What
does
that look like,
Ed? You know, Mason pulled up for that shot. Definitely got a little hit there by Nick O for his second foul. Mason's going to go to the line here. We have 34 seconds left in the halftime. And Boston's going to hold for the last shot here. We're going to get the ball in. We're going to roll around the top. Try to get a three. Send us into halftime with a big lead. So stay tuned here for the final 34 seconds here of the second quarter. Delaware was coached by Luke Vaughn. This is Luke's second year. He took over after longtime coach Jeff Broyles, who's the AD. Trying to get himself a first league win here in 2019-20.
No free throw points from Mason Montesolo.
When that ball gets lodged like that, that is a jump ball. It's going to be Rockland ball, so pending the jump ball, there's going to be Delaware ball coming in after the half. All right, I'm going to let you call this final 30 seconds of the first half. You go for it.
Think of these next 25 seconds. Darius is going to look for Emmanuel or Andre. You know, Andre's in there. He's only got one on him. Looking for two. Gerald Cummings here. Finds Darius again. Darius, he's Emmanuel going in behind. Still passes it to Gerald there. Gerald Cummings finds Darius. 5 seconds left on the clock. Darius finds Andre. Andre tries to put it up. And Emmanuel!
Emmanuel in there. Yeah, Emmanuel with the rebound, put back dunk. and a little chin-up. DeLore wants a technical on that chin-up. I'll tell you what, though. That's hard to call in high school basketball. That's the end of the second quarter. Rockland 40, DeLore 25. Now stay tuned for your senior cheerleaders, followed by the Rockland High School dance team. Congratulations to the senior Rockland cheerleaders out there in front.
Senior night for the high school basketball seniors, but it's also senior night for the cheerleaders and the dance squad. So we're going to go ahead and introduce the senior cheerleaders. Rockland High School would like to thank our class of 2020 cheerleaders. Thank you for the time you put in to support our school and athletic teams. This is an outstanding group of young women, and we wish them all the best for their next big adventure. You will all be missed. And these are a great bunch of girls. I've known them all since probably elementary school, and it's very, very good to see them graduating, and they're going to go on to bigger and better things. First off, say hi to Avery Ellis, Tanga Trammell, Haley Sharkey, sorry, Maddie Gomez Behar, Kyla Gerald, Stephanie Zhang, Kristen Toppings, Maddie Wicklund, Taylor Cruz, Bella McMillan, Sophia Busone, and Samantha Cranston. Those are your senior cheerleaders. Give it up for them, folks.
And now,
presenting the Rockland High School Dance Team.
Now, the Rockland Dance Team would like to thank this big senior class for their dedication to the family. They have helped develop on this team and to the success of this team on and off the dance floor. Our class of 2020 Dance Team alumni are Ashley Irwin, Caitlin Kahn, Ella Schwasnick, Emily Smith, Mackenzie Toll, Megan Davidson, Sila Penny, Deanna Giampoli, Sydney Eckenberg, Taylor Malloy. Thank you, girls, for everything you've done for the Rockland Dance Team, and good luck in your future endeavors. We have one more senior, folks. She's coming out onto the floor right now. All right, she needs no introduction. She's the Rockland High School feature twirler, Leah Mayer.
Girl, I'm down for you.
at St. Jude's is the Children's Hospital that we'll be donating to tonight. If you want to raise any money, if you want to give any money to the St. Jude's Hospital, our cheerleaders are going to be walking around the stands in a little bit with their megaphones. If you feel like it, donate for a great cause.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, let's get back to some high school basketball here. Once again, we got Rockland with a 15-point lead, 40 points, and DeLauro with 25 points. A minute 30 left until third quarter, second half. Let's see if DeLauro can make a comeback here, or if Rockland can just really put that lead ahead.
He came back too early.
They have a totally packed Rockland Thunder Storm.
All right, that's a great halftime show, huh? Leah really put on a show there tonight. Rockland dance team, Rockland cheer, and getting ready for a great second half. What'd you think about that first half, Arad?
You know, I think Rockland did a great job in the paint there. Andre early getting those dunks in. Emmanuel with the dunks, Donovan and Darius with the points. I think they're really getting in there early, what they should have done last game, but maybe they'll do the same as their last game and they'll actually go even harder a second half. What do you think, Doug?
I'll tell you what, when you get four dunks in the first half of a high school basketball game, that's pretty exciting stuff, especially here on Silent Night. How it was silent. Our crowd was not supposed to cheer for the first 10 points. We had two dunks in the first 2 points of the game. They did a great job. Cheerleaders did a great job. Dance team. This is a full-on performance for the sellout crowd here at Rockland High School. Really excited. Just to go over a couple things, Mason for Del Oro has 10 early points, the leading scorer for Del Oro. And for Rockland, Donovan Lopez has come out with a good 9 points in the first half as we start second half play.
Amazing here, we got Jared Hill here, JD Dudley. Aiden Perry to JD. Emmanuel on him, not letting him shoot, making him put the ball down. Still goes for the shot, and he does make the two. Emmanuel, really watching there. Like you said, JD Dudley, Dooley, 19 points average a game, and he's already made 10 with that 12 total throughout the game there.
I'll tell you what, that's just a good shot. Good defense, good shot. You got to give it to JD on that one.
JD pulls up for the shot, rolls off the rim. Got a defensive rebound from Ryland Dunmore. Doesn't make it to make that 42-27.
That was great play by Ryland on the defensive end and on the offensive end. He's going to be the number one tennis player for Del Oro this year as well. A lot of multi-sport athletes for Del Oro.
Got JD going in for another two.
Andre with a defensive rebound once again. He's got a lot of rebounds this game. Donovan finds
Bogdan. I'll tell you what, that was just a, I don't know if that was a smart foul by number 13 for Del Oro. Andre had the ball in his left hand going to score. We'll take it though. Put in the books and send him to the line. ...41-29 as we enter the third quarter here with 6:20 left. And Mason with the ball out on top, guarded by Donovan Lopez.
Got J.D. Dilley, pulls up for the shot. Bounces off rim there. Andre, back to Gerald, gets the rebound. Gerald finds Emmanuel. Emmanuel finds Darius, pulls up for three. Bounces off the rim. Got Rylan Dunmore there on the ball. Darius giving him no room.
I'll tell you what, the Del Oro fans wanted over the back on Andre there. He was over his back, but he wasn't on his back. No foul. Good call by the officials.
The officials seem to be making good calls, but the Del Oro crowd doesn't seem to be a fan of them. Probably why they're 0-7 this season.
Again, Andre, 6'5", he could jump, long arms. He's just taller. He's over their back.
Dominating this game. Manuel. Rylan Dunmore goes for three. Darius gets the ball.
Look for the alley-oop here.
Darius finds Donovan there. Gerald Cummings for three. Andre does manage to take the ball out of his hands, but it's like Mr. Perry, Aiden Perry, does still get the ball. JD for another three. Does not manage to get those points. Gerald crossover there. Gerald finds Donovan, goes for three. Rebound by Gerald there. Gerald just goes for two. And it looks like Mason Montesola staying on top of him, watching the ball. Aiden Perry goes for three, misses it. Gerald on a fast break here. Oh, there he is.
I think the crowd was poised for a rebound dunk by Emmanuel like he did to finish off the first half. You look at Emmanuel, he's smiling right now, knowing that he had that to put home. But Rockland gets a foul. Darius to the line. That was the first miss for Rockland after going 5-for-5. Typically, Rockland's shooting about 65% from the line, but not tonight.
Tonight, they're at a solid 80%.
Arad, some good math right there. Look at that.
Thank you.
Who's your math teacher this year, Mr. Arad?
Mr. Weckler, you know, fantastic math teacher. You know, if you really want to get good at math, I'd recommend coming here, Rockland High School.
Mr. Weckler, the pride of Del Campo High School here in Fair Oaks, California.
Darius does manage to make his second free throw, making that 5-for-6. Mason Montesola finds Aiden Perry. Back to Mason. Looks like he was going for a three. Finds JD instead. Back to Aiden. Aiden's trying to put it up. Evan Yanny finds the ball. Darius there. Darius trying to get past Aiden here. Goes for the three. That was nothing but net, ladies and gentlemen.
Buckets.
Put that bucket up. We got Mason pulls up for three. Nobody guarding him. Doesn't manage to make the shot, fortunately. The insult on what just happened?
I'll tell you what. Evan Mimi tried the Euro step there. And if the defender doesn't take the first step, it's going to be a charge. That's something new for the officials the last 2 years, this Euro step. Not only the officials have to watch for travel, but they got to watch for that block charge. And that first step right or left at their left foot is the key. And right there, the Del Oro defense did not move. It's going to be a charge.
Oh, Rylan Dunmore. Right into Nick. Oh,
pretty easy. pretty easy call for the officials right there. Ryland just lowered his shoulder. Nico had good defensive stance. Got to go to charge.
So after that foul, he does get subbed out for McLean Stonking.
It is Rockland ball, 47-29 with 3:47 left in the third quarter. Evan Nini. Got a foul on the ground there. Looks like we're going to take it out of bounds baseline. It's really good to see Luke Vaughn. He was very frustrated in the first half with the officials, but the coach of Del Oro is really trying to coach him up right now and letting the officials go.
Got Evan Niemi. Rebound. Tries to put it up. Rebound by Jared Hill. Got Mason Moncasola. Finds McLean. Back to Mason there. Oh! Looks like Cal Lunders could not get his hands on the ball there.
Kyle's the quarterback for the football team, not the receiver. Mason tried to hit him, though.
Darius going in here. Finds Evan. Evan back to Donovan. Donovan to Darius. Darius gets to Donovan. Byron Peterson with the rebound for the two. Looks like he's subbed in for Andre there, and he's still making it work.
Byron's had a knee issue all year, but I'll tell you what, when he gets in the game, when he gets healthy, hopefully he gets healthy for the playoffs, because we're gonna need Byron for the playoffs. So it looks like he's moving well right now. Got a good offensive board right there. Good Rockland defense, got the 10-second call. Rockland ball. Up 20. 2:57 left in the third quarter.
Got A.J. Bentor on the ball. A.J. finds Alex Portello. Alex Portello back to Nick O. A.J. to Byron. Evan tries to get in there. And he swivels that ball just cleanly in like a knife through butter. Jared Hill finds Kyle Lunders. Just tosses the ball right into Evan's face there.
Rockland, Del Oro will have 26 seconds left on the shot clock when they put this ball in play, down by 21.
Got Mason here on the ball.
Rockland's 6-1 in the SFL, tied for first place with Folsom. Looking to win the league this year. Ten seconds on the shot clock.
Mason Moncasola with a slip up there. JD Dully goes for two. Byron Peterson.
They pulled Byron's left arm there. Got the backcourt foul.
That was on Bill Wall. That's the fifth team foul. It'll be Rockland's ball out of bounds. We're going to be for Del Oro, number four, JT Maloney.
Mason, the leading scorer for Del Oro, is replaced in the lineup. Number 34, Colin Fenner, enters the game. AP comes up short.
It's like Byron doesn't let the ball go in there. We got JT, Jack Anderson, Evan Yemi. Nick O does get the two in.
Foul on Del Oro, that'll be their 16th foul.
That was a foul on Riley Burrows. He just entered the game.
We got Nico coming for two. First three throw, success.
Nick's had a great junior campaign. He started about three quarters of the games this year. Just a real versatile player. And even though he's only 5'6", he is a lockdown defender from the outside. Does a great job.
Both three throws made. Rockland just not giving up these opportunities, making sure they can get as many points as possible, utilizing their free throws with only one missed free throw.
Looks like we had a lot of photographers underneath the basket. They just cleared those out. That was a brief delay there. Rockland's still putting the pressure on. They're going to pressure full court all game long. Some people might say that's bad sportsmanship, but Rockland is preparing for the playoffs. Every game is for the playoffs. They do have their subs in, but they will continue in case we get into playoff situation.
Alex Botello comes close to making three there. AJ Bentour on the ball. Finds Byron. Got McClain Stilkey with the rebound.
Just under a minute to go here in the third quarter. Rod, it's 53-29 Rockland over Del Oro on the senior night here in Rockland. Got a sellout crowd. You look across the floor, the Storm section has done great tonight. And you can see they're all dressed in their flannels, giving homage to Del Oro here on Silent Night. It's a great crowd here in Rockland. And again, we have two more away games left. At Oak Ridge on Tuesday.
Jacob Birch gets two.
And then we'll finish off next Friday night at Whitney, crosstown rival. Again, should be another sellout crowd. Really looking forward to it. Rod, you going to be there on Friday night?
Definitely going to be there. Hopefully I'll be able to shoutcast that game as well because I'm really enjoying this.
Yes, it is. It is Valentine's Day next Friday night over at Whitney High School. Show the love of the Rockland community. Should be a great atmosphere, a great game. And Rockland looking to finish off their great season. Last second shot by AJ.
Got half a second on the clock here.
It should be 1.3 on the clock. Luke is calling for 1.3. Yes, looks like Aaron Gray is going to come over to Jonathan Nagel and going to have a discussion. Looks like they're going to put 2 seconds on the clock.
I feel like Del Oro, they've just had too many fouls. They've really got to pull back on those and not foul as much. As right now it's a 22-point lead. And I feel earlier they were at an 11-point lead for Rockland, but those free throws, I think those are what's mainly contributing to Rockland's points there, as they've utilized all of them and they've only missed one.
Yeah, Del Oro only has 6 points here in the third quarter. And they're trying to put 2 seconds back on the clock here. That is 16 fouls for Del Oro, as you said, Rob. Rockland will be shooting all fouls for the rest of the way here in the fourth quarter. Two seconds on the clock. Think they're going to go J.D. Dooley right here. Here he goes.
Goes for the shot. Bounces off the backboard. And that is the end of the third quarter, which rolls us right into our sponsor. Go ahead and take it from here, Eck.
All right. Once again, our broadcast here today, sponsored by David Petty Dentistry, your local dentist here in Rockland and Roseville. Dr. Petty, what a great program he runs over there in Roseville. He's my dentist. And he can be yours too. Why don't you give Dr. Petty a call? One of the sponsors here, Rockland High School. At your 2019-2020 Rockland High School varsity dance team. Give a shout out to my daughter out there, Sydney Eckenberg. This is her last dance performance, as it is senior night for the dancers as well. I should say, and all the other dancers. It's a great program.
Looks like we've got the last quarter here. 22-point lead for Rockland.
Rockland has some new faces out on the floor. Jimmy Summers returns, but Cole Becker, one of the top field goal kickers in all the land, junior Cole Becker.
Jimmy to Evan there. Looks like Delora Ball slipped out of bounds.
Also, senior Dylan Glenn is in the game. Good to get Dylan in the game as a senior. He's played all 4 years here at Rockland High School. Evan Nemi's also in the game, and AJ is also one of the starting crew here in the fourth quarter.
Got JD Dooley on the ball. JD Dooley trying to get in there, trying to get him open. Goes for the shot. AJ with a rebound.
Rockland on the break.
Like AJ was looking for Cole Becker there. Just managed to hit him on the shoulder.
Byron Hong back in the game. He started the game. Byron had to sit out all of last year while his paperwork was transferred. His family moved from Hong Kong. Good to see Byron get in the game.
Got Mason Montesola trying to force something there. Got Rylan Dunmore. It's two.
That was good elevation with Rylan on that one. Pulled up about 14 feet.
It's like Donovan going in for AJ. We got Darius back in for Dylan Glenn. Cole Becker on the ball. Finds Donovan. Donovan finds Darius. Darius fakes the three. Finds Jimmy. Jimmy's got Cody Tedford on him. Donovan finds Jimmy again. Stumbles on the ball there.
Out on the floor. On the ground. It'll be a 30-second timeout.
Looks like a timeout from Rockland. Wonder what Coach Taylor is telling his players to do with this 20-point lead. 6 minutes, 30 seconds left.
Well, you know, Rod, this is where the subs are in. This is valuable time for the subs. Rockland's rotation is about 8 players. And these are the times where these subs get playing time, not only for this year, but for next year. And in the playoffs, somebody gets into foul trouble. One of these players is going to have to come in and give us some valuable time. And this is where they need to work with some of the starters. Donovan Lopez is in the game. Darius is in the game. And they have got to continue to work and get better. So when their number's called in the playoffs next year, they're ready to go.
Cole Becker on the ball. Finds Donovan. Donovan pulls for three. Off the rim. Finds Darius. Darius back to Donovan. Looks like they're a duo here. Darius for three. That was nothing but net, ladies and gentlemen.
Once again, ladies and gentlemen, my name is Dale Eckenberg with Arad Ajadi. This is Rockland High School basketball on Rockland Broadcasting. This is only our third game. This is a learning environment. We're all learning out here, so hope you enjoy the broadcast tonight. And we're going to be back with you for some baseball later on in the season. And next year, look for us at football and all the basketball games. We're just getting rolling with Rockland Broadcasting, and we want to thank you for joining us tonight.
Donovan finds Byron Hong. Jimmy Summers on the ball. Back to Donovan there. Donovan and Cole Becker puts it up for two. It looks like the big men for Rockland, they're absolutely crushing it this game. Unbelievable the work they're putting out. JD goes for his next shot. Cole Becker with the rebound. Donovan finds Jimmy. Jimmy's getting in there. It looks like it bounces off his foot, unfortunately.
Hey, Rod. How many many points did JD have the first time we played him?
He had 22 points against us.
I'll tell you what, he's only got 8 points tonight. That's why the score is 58-33, Rockland dominating. They're really shutting down JD Dooley tonight.
I think that was one of our keys we spoke about at the beginning, and you know, Rockland's doing a good job of shutting him down. It looks like Mason Moncasola could also use some shutting down, as he's clearly a key player for Del Oro Eagles basketball team. Looks like the ball's back to JT. We got McLean Stone King whiffs the shot. Oh, looks like the ball got out of Jerry's hands there.
Michael Magnum is into the game, as well as Dylan Glenn. Coach Taylor letting the senior come in. The crowd wanted Dylan. Dylan's in.
You got Michael watching Rylan Dunmore. Tries to put it up.
Ooh. Now into the game for Rockland, number 33. Rock Henry ball. Cowles.
We got Henry Cowles in there, number 33.
This fourth quarter's flying by. Very little fouls. Subs are playing well. And once again, 58-33 Rockland. 4 minutes, 22 seconds left in the game here tonight.
Cole Becker goes for three, and he manages to make it. Stunning performance from Cole Becker. You know, not only has he been there for the rebounds, but he's also been there pulling up for threes. Mason Moncasola tries to go for a very long shot there. What was the ref's call?
That was NBA range right there.
Good job, Cole. Oh, yeah, Becker.
The officials are coming together on that. They might be changing their ruling on that. They had to reset the shot clock on that air ball by Mason, but he shot that from a long ways. That was Harlem Globetrotter territory out there.
I was on Rockland. It's the 14th JD. The pass in. Back to Rylan Dunmore. Finds McLean there. JD goes in. And he makes the two. Del Oro crowd with the clapping. Michael Mangum on the ball here. Finds Henry Cowles. Henry Cowles trying to get in there. Jordan Flores. Henry looks like a... What was that called there?
I think everybody wanted Henry to shoot, and he did too, and then he changed his mind. And too late. He walked. You know what's nice, though, Rod, is that the Rockland subs have been in this whole fourth quarter, and we've extended the lead against many of Del Oro's starters. So, again, Rockland basketball extremely deep. We talked in the girls about how young we are. Here's Michael Magnum right here, a junior. Oh!
Looks like he slipped up there. Air ball from number 4, Rylan Dunmore.
JT Maloney. A rebound from Dylan Glenn.
Andrew Cowles almost got the ball in there.
The crowd was willing that ball in for Henry. They want to get a score from all these guys who don't always get in, but they work hard in practice, and this is their time right here.
Like Cody Tedford pulled up for the shot. The shot for number 12, Al Lunders.
It's
like a foul from Rockland. We got JT Maloney taking out the ball. Got some substitutes.
Timeout on the floor, DeLoro. It'll be a 30-second timeout.
It's like a timeout. Apologies. We got Rockland with the 26-point lead, 61-35. 2 minutes and 23 seconds left in the fourth quarter. I think Rockland's going to take it home tonight.
We are going to take it home tonight. And at 61-35, all the subs are in. Everybody's working hard. You look at Andre Renica, he's in the huddle. All the starters are making sure that these subs get quality time. We're just going to finish this thing out. And we'll see you on Tuesday in El Dorado Hills at Oak Ridge High School, the home of the Trojans, for Rockland basketball. We will not be on the air on Tuesday, but follow us on Max Preps. They should have live scoring going on. And then, of course, follow us on Friday night at Whitney.
Rockland,
this is Jack Anderson at the line for the Eagles.
Jack Anderson, make the first free throw.
Always nice to get in the scorebook.
So we got Daniel Grimes, the rebounds. Back to Michael Mangum. Andrew Cowles to Jordan Flores. Jordan finds Dylan Glenn. Dylan goes for three. The crowd is absolutely ramped up for that three from Dylan Glenn. The crowd is restless tonight. After that 10 point, the crowd just absolutely has been going off.
That's a great moment for Dylan Glenn. Pointed up in the stands at mom and dad. You gotta love when Dylan Glenn gets in the game. These guys are hard workers. They come, they work Junior Thunder, they work with their young people. Dylan Glenn's in our athletic leadership class. And as you can see, the players are really happy for Dylan. And the crowd's happy for Dylan. It's a great scene here at Rockland High School. And we still got more. We got 136 left.
Like Henry Cowles with the shot, and he sinks that with no effort. Absolutely effortless, just showing off.
Everybody's scoring tonight. You gotta love high school basketball. You know, everybody's getting in the game. This is what high school basketball is all about. And it's a great crowd out here. Everybody's cheering each other on. And this is why I teach. It's a lot of fun, a lot of great crew. After 21 years, this stuff never gets boring. Henry Callis's mom's over here texting, sending photos to grandma. You gotta love it. You gotta love high school basketball. I believe she's crying, Arad. Is she crying? I think mom's crying.
Looks like she is tearing up a little bit, but that's just beautiful. Well, Henry just pulled up for that three, absolutely sunk it. Still in the game.
Crowd goes wild. She's watching it again on her phone. She's smiling. Gotta love it. I think we gotta get AP a three here, or maybe Byron over there. He's gotta get a three. Here comes AP, they set the screen. Kick out to Dylan. Oh, Henry with the rebound.
Henry with the rebound. His mom was too busy watching the three he made to actually witness the two. She looks up just as the ball goes in. Hopefully she'll be able to catch it back on the replay.
Dad saw it, dad's bragging. Henry Collins for three. Oh. Just came up a little left.
Got JT Maloney. Cody Tedford goes for the shot. Dylan Glenn with the rebound.
That's going to be the ball game, Arad.
Looks like you got 13 seconds left on the clock, 69 to 43. Let's see if Henry can make one more three.
It's over, Arad. Good sportsmanship by Rockland. That'll be your final, Rockland 69, Yellow Arrow 43.
Today was just an absolutely beautiful night of high school basketball. Truly a good performance by both sides. Rockland just coming out on top. Outstanding.
That's going to conclude our broadcasting, Arad. I just want to say thank you. Hopefully you learned a lot. I learned a lot. And stay tuned for more Rockland sports. Arad, I'll let you wrap it up, buddy.
Today was just phenomenal, you know. Both teams really pulled up. 69-43. Everyone is piling out onto the court. But it's our second broadcast ever of Rockland High School. I'm Arad Ajadi, signing off with Dale Leckenberg. Hopefully, next Friday at Whitney, we'll be able to have our third broadcast.
We'll have to talk with the Whitney High School with that, but as we go, drive safe. See us in the playoffs. Go Rockland High School.
See you later, Rockland.